in the battle dress. The NCO wears boots. He always has. Well, almost. Many soldiers at Valley Forge did not have shoes, much less boots. They marched and fought with no more than rags that were wrapped around bleeding, frostbitten feet. Those volunteers literally knew the meaning of a come-as-you-are war. From the crude, rough, and soiled moccasins worn by soldiers more than 225 years ago, to the smooth and polished jump boots, to the tan suede boots of today, boots have been basic to soldiering. Whether strapped, laced, buttoned, buckled, or wrapped by leggings, boots have marched, paced, sloshed, trampled, jumped, and charged over or through dirt, mud, snow, brush, rock, sand, and water. In peace and war, the boots of the American soldier left their prints in many places. From Yorktown, Little Bighorn, Shiloh, San Juan Hill, Luzon, Cantigny, Koblenz, Omaha Beach, Iwo Jima, Kaisan, St. George's, Sinai, Gander, Panama City, and Kuwait City, to name just a few. With boots on, U.S. soldiers have fought wars, policed cities, stood between hostile forces, provided humanitarian relief, rescued civilians, and died. Boots have been buried with soldiers, removed from bodies, amputated along with legs, and shattered by mines. No matter where, when, or what the mission, an Army non-commissioned officer was there, wearing boots.